I'm Sophie Lichaba, formerly Naba, and I'm a mother, I'm a wife, I'm an entrepreneur, I'm a philanthropist, I am a lover of life, I'm a lover of God, I'm a lover of everything. Fabulous. It's lifestyle, it's family orientated, it's Ubuntu, it's real, it's current, it's not a shwashwi kind of show, it's not indabazabantu, it's more, let's talk about a topic that affects our society and we discuss it, whether it may be children, it may be fashion, whether it may be money, whether it may be anything, something that we saw somebody's going through. And you know, we've got a segment called Han DMC, and our Han DMC people write into us and they say, hey, I have a problem, my husband wants to divorce me because my phone was off for half the day and it's never been off. I personally was hurt because I thought he should be worried about where I am, but he's more, you know, thinking I was somewhere and doing untoward things. Why would he think that? Is it because he's doing it? Please help me. And you know, so we're not necessarily agony aunts kind of style, but we are there to say even what you think is silly. People always need help. People always need advice. So because we're a panel, it's not like day one. Because we're a panel, we are able to then get high, she's crazy. Somebody else will say, hi, but she's right. He shouldn't do that. So it's nice like that. Disappointed in society when I was going through that. You know, everybody talking about it on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all our social media platforms in general. I think, you know, once you become a celebrity per se, obviously you put yourself out there for people to talk about you. But I don't think any one person has a right to assume who they think you are as an individual, as a person, as such. Not that as a persona who's a performer, but as an individual. So for me, it was people need to start waking up, being sensitive, and understanding ukuthi, if you think I am this, have you taken a moment to look at yourself and say, what if it's you? Because sometimes you can live with HIV for a long time and not even know you have it. You can have cancer and only find it at the last stages where it's, you've got 3 months to live. You know, so really that perception, and I can say whatever I want, people need to wake up and move away from that. Oh yeah, I mean, the plans obviously is new shows. You'll see them as they come, as we unpack them. But I think also the responsibility I have to society, I'm a child of God, and I just think sometimes Ngulungulu puts you through something because of a sense of purpose. And I think over and above the fact that I am a diabetic, I'm living, I'm fabulous. So already that's my answers. Ugoti was never designed to destroy me, you know. Yes, I had some mishaps, but I can help others prevent it. So being an advocate of being, you know, of diabetes, I feel I have that responsibility and that weight on my shoulders that just keeps pressing me to say, when are you doing it? The blog, the, you know, YouTube, probably adding a few things every week, every month, sharing about why it's important to get tested. How simple is it to test? Because, you know, HIV stressed a lot of people to think more tests, that there's something big happening. And yet people are living with all these interesting diseases that, you know, they're killer diseases. But diabetes is one of the most uncomfortable diseases. And if you know how to manage it, you have a fabulous life. So it's, the blog is really there to educate on food, educate on lifestyle. When you're going out with friends, you don't have to say no. You just say, give me a little bit of a glass. It won't kill you, but flush it out. So you start learning the secrets of living with diabetes, and those who don't have it then are learning through the show, through that blog, to prevent it. And hopefully one day soon it will be a show on TV.